All right, I'm going to show you how to group your dates in a report. So to do that, we got to create a report. Here I'm going to create a brand new report, and I'm just going to create an opportunity report. You could pick any report type you like, but this is a fairly common type that most people create. Now, this is my standard report, but just to simplify things for this video, I'm going to remove all the columns and create a very, very basic report. So in this report, let's say we want our opportunity name, let's say dollar amount. Everyone always wants sales stage. We'll add sales stage here. And even close date. Now notice there's a couple close dates available. This is special for the opportunity object. We'll talk about it later. But for this demo, just pick a date field. You pick any date field you want, and we add that to your report. So here I'm just going to add closed dates. All right, and you can add more fields. There are a lot of other date fields as well, like the created date, last modified date. If you're not sure what date fields you have access to, you can always open up this little field drawer on the side of the page and just filter down and see just all of your date fields that are available based on this report type. And you could just, you know, close the field if you want, or you can move the fields from this drawer into your report just by dragging and dropping. And look, there's my last activity date on these opportunities. But just to simplify, I'm going to remove that column. Here we've got name, amount, stage, and close date. And you can see every opportunity with its own individual dates, and we could just run the report right now. But let's group by the date. So I could just drag and drop the close date field up there, or you could search for the field individually. But there we go, we've now grouped by date, okay? And notice it's no longer a column. The column is missing because it's been turned into a grouping. So there are 9 deals on October 1st, 2 on the 2nd, 8 on the 4th. So it's really just grouped at each individual day. Each day is different. That's not really what most of you are going to want to report on. So you click on the little arrow at the top of the column and you select how you'd like to group your date. Do you want to group by month? Do you want to group by quarter? Do you want to group by calendar quarter or fiscal quarter? Here at Salesforce, our fiscal calendar starts in February, so our fiscal quarter is different than our calendar quarter. So just scroll down, there's a couple options here, but this is how you're going to group your days differently. So here we'll just do calendar month, that's what most people want, and now you can see how many deals are in October. Now we can even add more grouping, so you can group by month, then by stage. So here, for example, show me all the deals in October, and then break them down further by sales stage. Or, you know, you could do the other way around. The date doesn't need to be the topmost grouping. You could group by stage and then by month. Here, I'm just gonna edit the filters on my report to just get a little bit more data in here across time. But here you go. Here's 4 deals in the qualification stage, some in October, some in September. And you can just go back and forth. But the real problem here is that you're gonna miss the created date column. So now you're grouping by month, but you can't see the close date as a field. So what Salesforce did is they created a duplicate close date field for you specifically. Now you have 2 close dates. You can drag one onto the report to view it as a column, and you can use the other one as a grouping. So you can still group by month and still yet see the close dates for each opportunity. Now, in general, you may not have that on whatever date field you're interested in. So you can create what are called these row level formulas. So you can create your own little formula field right there in the report and essentially just copy whatever date field you like. So if you want to make your own secondary date field or secondary number field or what have you, you can. And there's actually a lot of formulas and functions you can even apply to date fields. So if you want to know what day of the week, and maybe exclude Saturdays. Those are things you can do when you start adding more functions and formulas to it. But now we've got our report, we're grouping by date, and really the whole point is most people want a chart, so you adjust your chart in your report, and you can start playing with the settings on, do you want to see how many deals, or do you want to see the sum of amount of the deals by month? And if you had groupings and subgroupings, you can even have your charts take on those groupings and subgroupings as well. The entire configuration of the report chart is really going to be based on the configuration of your report. So if you want to group your chart by month by stage, then you need to group your report by month and stage. All right, I hope this was helpful. I hope you now feel a little bit more comfortable creating a report, grouping the date fields by month, by quarter, by year, and then even creating your own row level formula so you can both group by the field and still see it as a column in your report. And if you like this video and you want to learn more about Salesforce, come join me. I run a webinar every Tuesday and Thursday where you can come learn a little bit about Salesforce and ask me questions live. Hope to see you there.